Hello, welcome back to another episode of the Natural Aquarium. Today we're going to examine one of the foundations of most natural freshwater bodies on Earth, leaf litter. Not only does it provide nutrients and habitats, but it can do much more for your natural aquarium. So let's go ahead and dive right in and see why you should be adding some to your aquarium.
First things first, let's talk about where to get leaves and which ones to grab. I prefer this cottonwood right here, part of the poplar family. And I go for all of these dark leaves that are sitting on the ground, ones that have been there for a while. And you can tell that they've been there for a while because, well, they're already starting to decay. That means that their nutritional value is actually increased due to fungi and bacteria. The ones I try to avoid are the ones that are still light colored, they look like they just fell off the tree somewhat recently, so I leave those behind. Now, there are some exceptions to the rule, like this alder here. It can be a little bit green and still be fine, but generally you don't want to pull the ones that are still on the tree because the tree is still pulling sugars out of them. Friendly reminder that the only litter we should be finding on the ground is leaf litter. Next up is another local favorite of mine, the American sycamore. The American sycamore's leaves tend to last a bit longer than the poplar ones, and variety is the spice of life here, folks. The more different leaves that you can put in there, the better for your aquarium. Each one has different nutritional capabilities, and will provide those to your fish. Another interesting thing to add would be some of the seed pods from some of these plants, like the jacaranda here. The jacaranda has these wonderful little wavy seed pods that split open, and they just make interesting little hiding places for all the little things to escape from your fish. You might even find little spinners like this, and they can be good too, as long as they're not fresh. If you're not a fan of the humic or tannic substances that some of these leaves can add, well, you can always soak them ahead of time, and this is also an opportunity to build up a little bit of biofilm before you introduce them into your aquarium. That way, things like shrimp and snails can feed from this biofilm. And if you were able to obtain your leaves from a natural water source, you wouldn't have to worry about doing any of this because it would be done for you. In fact, taking leaves from nature is probably one of the best things you can do for your aquarium in providing nutrition and biodiversity. If you're looking for certain qualities for your aquarium, you can always check out the ones that we have listed in our book. As your leaves break down inside of your aquarium, they'll release a whole treasure trove of organic compounds into your water. So you can think of it as like a slow-release compost for your mulm layer. They'll release things like tannins, which can slightly alter the pH, have some very specific antimicrobial capabilities, and generally reduce the stress of your fish. There's also humic acids, which will improve the nutrient uptake for plants. There are micronutrients such as iron, calcium, magnesium, and many others. And they've got plenty of polysaccharides, aka sugars, that will feed your bacteria and fungi, the base of your food chain, making them a lovely area for a buffet of biofilm. Let's talk about the guys that are going to do the most heavy lifting when it comes to breaking it down. We call them shredders. And these are any of the organisms that are going to be chomping these leaves into tiny little bits. First up are isopods. Isopods are great little additions to your tank. They're very peaceful, and all they want to do is munch this plant material all day long. By tearing the leaves into smaller pieces, there's actually more surface area for bacteria to colonize. Another aquarium favorite is the amphipod, aka scuds. These guys are also great shredders, again, manipulating the leaves into smaller pieces, allowing for better colonization of bacteria and fungi. More likely than not, if you gather your leaves from a natural source, you'll actually have some of these guys attached to them. So, hey, free food for your fish, right? If you do not have these shredders in your aquarium, you will note that your leaves will take much longer to decay without them. While the amphipods are able to make the leaves more digestible for bacteria and fungi, the fungi and bacteria also make it more digestible for the scuds. Amazing. Another creature you're bound to find hiding on your leaves are going to be ostracods. These lovely little guys are just grazing on the biofilm of these decaying leaves, eating fungal hyphae and other microbial things that they find. They're an important part of nutrient cycling, and the feeding of this biofilm will help free up the nutrients that were originally in the leaf, and they will help deposit those in the mulm, which will eventually end up going to feed your plants in your aquarium. They are a way to tell that you have a healthy, biodiverse food web forming, as they are at the bottom level doing lots of scavenging. They can also be the favored food of many fish that are able to eat them whole. and they're usually pretty sustainable inside of your aquarium as they're able to survive in some extreme oxygen-poor environments and burrow down into the mulm. One other organism that's much like the ostracods are the copepods. Copepods are also going to be grazing on biofilm that they find on top of the leaf and also eating general detritus. And just like the copepods, they will be helping to break down all these complex organic molecules that are found in these leaves and the things that eat them and return them back to the mulm to eventually be taken up by the plants. Also, like the ostracods, they're a great food source for your fish that can be very sustainably maintained inside of your aquarium so long as you have enough places for them to inhabit. Leaves help maintain invertebrate biodiversity in your aquarium, and these invertebrates then go on to help maintain your plants, which maintain your fish. And we shouldn't forget supporting our shrimp as well. Our lovely shrimp friends, if I ever need to find one, I simply need to look to the leaves. They're there like little machines grazing on all the biofilm, the fungi, any little things that are building up on these leaves, even algae. So if you're looking for healthy shrimp, look no further. Add some leaves to your tank. It'll feed them in the most natural way possible. And of course, other parts of the tree can count as well, like seed pods, bark, wood. Remember, there is benefit to soaking these in some aquarium water before adding them to your aquarium to build up biofilm for these guys. And where would we be without my friends the snails? They graze on these leaves with their little radula, sanding it down, exposing more and more surface area for more bacteria to colonize, furthering the breakdown. They, like shrimp, are actually drawn to these leaves, especially ones that have been colonized by bacteria and fungi. They release little chemicals out into the water that they will then pick up on and immediately race over to start eating this wonderful food. So what actually happens when the leaf goes in your tank? Well, the first is the soaking phase, which the leaf softens, begins to release tannins and humic substances. Next is your biofilm colonization with a slimy layer of rich microorganisms. Third is our fragmentation, in which our shrimp, our snails, our detritivores, our shredders, they come in and break that leaf down physically. And then finally, you end up having our fourth step, integration, in which all of these little pieces become part of the mulm, eventually feeding bacteria and plants. Before we push and go smaller and see what's happening at the cellular level, I thought I'd center in on one of my favorite things. It is the American sweet gum seed pods. These pods are amazing little places with tons of nooks and crannies, perfect hiding place for many microorganisms, which you might be spotting right now if you are able to see it. I know it's a little blurry, but there's stentors all over the surface of this. They're sitting there with their little cilia, pulling all sorts of food into their little tube-like mouths there. Here's what they look like under a microscope. We can go further and further down the rabbit hole, seeing smaller and smaller organisms that rely upon this leaf litter and that can eventually benefit your fish. We are now witnessing the tiny cellular structures of the leaves. These cell walls that make the geometric structures that you're seeing are being broken down. This is all made of sugars, sugars that become softer and easier able to be digested by various microorganisms that feed on it. All the complex macromolecules that the plant put together when it was alive are now being broken down into their most basic forms, releasing the carbon, the nitrogen, and the phosphorus back to the water to be used by other organisms. It is important to try and seek out leaves from nature, especially in water, because there are a variety of different fungi and different bacteria that do different jobs, and without them, they do not all benefit. While we most enjoy the view of the larger creatures in the aquarium, it is here, these mysterious shadows, where most of the work is actually done, that helps keep the entire ecosystem stable and alive. So maybe appreciate them a little bit more, and don't be afraid to keep your aquarium not sterile.
Thanks for joining us on another episode of The Natural Aquarium. Hopefully I've given you enough cause not to leaf any of this out of your aquarium. If you like the video, we do enjoy likes and subscribes. Those help grow the channel and get these videos out to more people. And if you got a favorite leaf or piece of wood or anything that you like to use in your aquarium, we'd love to hear it in the comments down below. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time. Stay curious.